नमो नमः। उत्साह, साहसम, धैर्यम, बुद्धिः, शक्तिः, पराक्रमः, षड् येते यत्र तिष्ठन्ति तत्र देवो अपि तिष्ठति। पर्सिवियरेंस, डेयरिंग, करेज, विजडम, स्ट्रेंथ एंड वैलर, वेयर दीज सिक्स एग्जिस्ट देयर एग्जिस्ट गॉड, सेज द सुभाषितम। वेरी गुड टेस्टिमनी टू द सुभाषितम इज द लेजेंड ऑफ तिरुमरिसै आळ्वार, who showed all these virtues in his devotion to Lord Vishnu. So Tirumarisai Aalvar and his disciple Kanikannan were living in Tirumarisai in Kanchipuram. So once it so happened that they restored the youth of an old woman who subsequently married the ruler of the land. So the king also then, he also desired to have his youth restored. He was also old, so he wanted to become young again. And so he summoned for Kanikannan and Tirumarisai Aalvar to do the needful and also to sing his praise. But the two of them refused to sing the praise of any mortals. They would sing only in praise of the Lord. So this angered the ruler greatly and he banished Kanikannan. So when Kanikannan left, Tirumarisai Aalvar also decided to leave, because he was his disciple and he was a great devotee of the Lord. So he also decided to leave. Then he turned around and he looked at the Lord and he said, Kanikannan is going, I am going, what are you doing here? You have no work here anymore. Roll up your serpent bedding and follow us. So that is the kind of authority he exercised on the Lord. And sure enough, the Lord followed the two of them. So to describe this incident, Tirumarisai Aalvar composed a Pasuram which describes this incident. Let me read it out for you. Kanikannan pogindran kamaru poongkachi. Kanikannan is leaving Kanchipuram. Manivanna, nee kidakka venda. Oh Lord, you don't have to be here. You don't have to recline here anymore. Tuni udaya chenna pulavanum chelgindren. I am the poet and I am also leaving. I am also going behind Kanikannan. Neeyum unran pai nagappai churtikkol. You two roll up your serpent bedding and follow the two of us. And sure enough, the Lord followed the two of them. And what happened to the city of Kanchipuram? It became desolate and there was drought and famine. The ruler soon realized his folly and he was in repentance. He summoned for Kanikannan and he prayed for him to come back to his city, so that bounty will return to his city. So Kanikannan comes back and along with him the Aalvar also comes back. Now the Aalvar commands the Lord and he says, okay, the two of us are returning. You again roll up your serpent bed and come and lie here. Open it up here and lie here like before, he says. So the Pasuram goes like this. Kanikannan pok korindan kamaru poongkachi. Manivanna, nee kidakka vendum. Oh Lord, you have to come and recline here. துணி உடைய சென்னா புலவனும் செலவொழிந்தான். நீயும் உன்றன் பை நாகப்பாய் படுத்துக்கொள். யூ டூ கம், ஓப்பன் அப் யுவர் சர்பன் பெட்டிங் அண்ட் கம் அண்ட் லை ஹியர். So, and the Lord follows. He comes back. He comes back to the city. Therefore, yathotkari or sonna vannam seitha perumal is what this Lord is called, because he obeyed the diktat of Tirumarisai Aalvar. He was a slave to Tirumarisai Aalvar, because that is what happens to devotees. The Lord becomes the slave of the devotees, and that is what is seen here in this Pasuram. However, coming back to the Subhashitam, the perseverance and the daring, the courage that and the daring that the authority that Tirumarisai Aalvar exercises over the Lord shows that he is the greatest bhakta of the Lord, and no wonder, as the Subhashitam says, shad yete yatra tishthanti, wherever these virtues stay, tatra devo api tishthati. Sure enough, the Lord stays where Tirumarisai Aalvar stays. Namo namaha.